heading deep into the hills, 4 hours outside Kathmandu, up sandy roads and through devastated towns, we came to one village that was practically leveled.
So this is your house.
The poorest villages are the ones that have been the hardest hit by this earthquake. The reason is people here can't afford bricks or cement. So all of their homes are made out of rough field stone and mud.
I was giving my daughter a bath when the earthquake came. We ran away and I watched our house crumble to the ground.
Jitmaya's husband died a few years ago. Now she and her daughter live with her mother-in-law. Our SUV was too heavy to make it all the way to their village, so we had to offload the relief supplies and trek them in the rest of the way. Once we got set up, we gave tarps and blankets to everyone there.
It is so nice to see people coming here to help us. We didn't know what we would do without our home.
Soon, villagers here will start rebuilding their homes and their lives. But rebuilding takes time. You know, it's getting kind of dark, but it is nowhere near dusk. I can hear the thunder in the distance, and that means the rainy season is coming. When the rains come, CBN teams will continue to provide food, shelter, and medical care to the people of Nepal.